Let me begin by thanking the people of my constituency, Patiala, for giving me the time to represent them here in Parliament. I assure them I will do my very best to carry their voice to be heard in this august house. Mr. Chairman, we are indeed blessed to be here at a time when we observe a very historic year. This is the year of the 550th birth anniversary of our first Guru, Guru Nanak Dev Ji. It is also the year of the 150th birth anniversary of our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi Ji, the centenary of Jallianwala Bagh, and also the 70th year of our constitution. These historic events, the importance can be underscored by a strong affirmation of the ideals of the constitution and the visions of our forefathers. I am sure that all of us collectively, irrespective of parties and states that we represent, will strive to strengthen our commitment to the values of our constitution and in the process strengthen our democracy. In his address to Parliament, to both the houses, the President of India touched upon many important issues. Some of these have been highlighted by many of the esteemed members. Allow me to draw attention to some of the issues that I consider that will impact the people of Punjab whom I represent. Punjab has always occupied a very special place in the hearts of India. Punjabis have always been in the forefront of everything, be it giving the nation its much needed food security or guarding its frontiers. In the state, we witnessed 2 decades of militancy-related violence and were also the theater of 2 wars with Pakistan. In the 70s and 80s, we witnessed the Green Revolution, which gave great prosperity to our state. But I'm sorry to say that today, this Andata state is in what we call a severe crisis. Our groundwater table stands totally depleted and our farmers are in acute state of debt. The treatment that the centre has been given has not done much, and the need for a debt waiver, total debt waiver scheme for all the farmers is very acute. So the state government of Punjab has done its bit by giving some relief because it has very limited resources. I call upon the Prime Minister, because the situation is similar with the farmers all over the country, to do a one-time debt waiver scheme and help us out. To add insult to injury, the state of Punjab has been burdened with a huge financial debt of 31,000 crores, which has been imposed on us due to non-reconciliation of the food account. It's quite ironic that we purchase food for the government of India and then end up by paying 3,000 crores every year as interest on that debt. And this will probably continue for the next 20 years. So I call upon the Finance Minister to find an equitable solution to end this. Punjab is facing a very serious water problem. On the one hand, its irrigation system is old and dilapidated, and it needs urgent upgradation, for which I hope the government of India will clear a project soon. On the other hand, the water table is declining alarmingly, and the reality of Punjab becoming a desert state is quite real. I call upon the Agriculture Minister to increase the subsidy on the underground irrigation pipe scheme and save our precious water resource. Our state's border areas are very thickly populated, unlike other states. And the meager grants given by the central government under the border area development programs are like a small drop of water in the ocean. The government of India must come forward and assist the state through a special package for the development of these border areas. And also the flight of industry from these areas, first due to militancy and then due to the special packages given to the neighboring hill states, has seriously compromised the economic health of Punjab. Let me now turn to some specific issues related to Patiala, my constituency. There's been a long pending proposal to declare Patiala Sarhind Morinda as a national highway and to four-lane it. This road connects many shrines of historical and religious importance from Patiala, Fatehgarh Sahib to Chinkor Sahib. There has been a demand to name this highway as after Mata Gujari Ji, the mother of Dasham Pita, Sri Guru Gobind Singh Ji. I request the Union Transport and Highways Minister to conclusively approve this project, as it has been approved earlier, but the work has never been initiated. A related issue and the approval of the construction of a ring road round Patiala under the Bharat Mala scheme has been put forward. I'm given to understand that 6 towns of the state have been given but not approved. I can only request the Union Minister Gadkari Sahib not to deprive our state of this legitimate share of development. Patiala, as you know, is declared a counter-magnet town of the NCR by the Ministry, and this only strengthens our case for approval of the Ring Road. I call upon the Housing and Urban Affairs Minister to include Patiala in the new towns to be taken up under the Smart Cities program. I feel that all the counter-magnet towns of states around Delhi should be in this scheme, whether it's Patiala or Hisar. I will conclude by saying that the people of Punjab look to the Government of India with hope that they will provide them their rightful due in the true spirit of corporate federalism. Mr. Chairman, sir, Punjab has always stood by the nation. So it's high time that the nation stood by Punjab and recognized and addressed its legitimate demands. Thank you.